Hello and welcome back to Tasting with Teas. I am back with another video. Today we are making croquettes. I'm not going to say salmon croquettes, but I have mackerel today. It's similar to salmon, just a little cheaper. You can use salmon if you like. Our ingredients, we have all-purpose flour, cornmeal, one egg, bell pepper, onion, a half of a bell pepper, half of an onion, or actually a half of an onion, about a quarter of a bell pepper. We have black pepper, Cajun seasoning, lemon pepper, garlic powder, and parsley. So I have mixed the flour with the cornmeal, and I'm gonna stir it up and get it mixed all up and good, and I'll show you what we have next. All right, y'all, I'm back. So I have all the mackerel in the bowl. I decided, to make some alterations. So I added about a tablespoon of mayo and a teaspoon of mustard just to give it a tang kind of flavor. The mayo will make it creamy in addition to the egg that we'll be adding. And I'm also going to add some panko crumbs. Now you can add regular breadcrumbs, but I rather use these because they're very crunchy and it will make it not so bready, right? Another tip I wanted to give you guys was to, if you don't have any cornmeal or flour or either or, you can use any kind of fish fry. I prefer the seasoned because then you can omit all of the ingredients that you see here today. And all you'll have to do is just mix it up, add your egg, your panko breadcrumbs or your regular breadcrumbs, and you'll be ready to go. All right, so I'm gonna get this stirred up and we'll be back to fry it. Okay, y'all, so our salmon croquettes are formed perfectly, about the size of the palm of your hand. That's how big you want them. If you like them bigger or smaller, hey, do your thing. It's up to you. I want to put a little bit of water. That's how you know that it's ready. I have my pan on a medium high heat as always. So what we'll do is just lay this first one in just like that. Let it form, put the other one in. And you can use a bigger pan. I just decided to use this one because I had already put the oil in it, but we'll let these fry. You want to let them get to a golden brown, about 3 to 5 minutes, maybe on each side, depending on your burner. And then you'll flip it to the other side, take it out, and I have some paper towels here that I'm gonna add it to soak up all that oil. And we'll be back to show you our finishing product. Okay, so I wanna show you guys something real quick. When I put my chicken, pork chops, croquettes, whatever, in a pan, I like to kind of spring the grease on top of it because then it allows it to get a little crunch on the top while it's cooking on the bottom as well. You don't have to, but I definitely recommend it. The ingredients and measurements will be listed in the comments below, or the description rather, so you can check that out there. I bet you're wondering what's going in here. So I decided to make some homemade southern grits, y'all. Yes, sweet and savory. We're going to just have a few ingredients. All you need is some coarse ground grits. I have a half a cup of water, some half and half cream, about a half a tablespoon of cheddar cheese just for a kick, and 2 tablespoons of butter. So I'm gonna add the grits here, stir this up, and we're gonna show you what it looks like. All right, y'all, so I have added the grits in here, cut my fire down. I'm adding my 2 tablespoons of butter, and I'm gonna add a douse of cream, not too much, because you don't want them too loose. And then we're gonna add that cheddar cheese in as well, just like so, and about a pinch of pepper, okay? So we'll stir this up, let it get nice and creamy. Yes, this is how you want your grits. Nobody wants grits that are lumpy, that are thick, nice and creamy. Look at that, y'all. You will add a little bit of salt to taste. I probably will add a little bit of Cajun seasoning just because it's southern. So we'll add that in there. Okay, y'all, so we are done with our mackerel croquettes, aka salmon croquettes, but whichever you prefer, and our cheesy savory southern grits. I have ended it with some cheddar cheese on top, a douse of Cajun seasoning and parsley for color. So I hope you enjoy this recipe. I hope that you give it a try. Comment, like, subscribe, and share. And if y'all know me, I'm a Southern girl, so I will be adding a little sugar to my grits. Okay, I'll see y'all next time with Tasting the Teas. Thanks for watching.